A cold email is basically where the customer does not know you or about your products. Okay, so that's what I would call cold email when you are approaching the customer for the first time. Or sometimes it may be that the customer knows you well in the past, but for some time, you know, for a reasonable time period, you have lost touch with him. Now, when you are approaching him once again, it becomes a cold email because you are reintroducing yourself about your company, about your products or services. So writing a cold email is basically your first virtual interaction to the customer, and it decides whether you will get any further audience with the customer. So it has to be the best effort that you have to put, as they say, you know, the best foot being put forward. The cold email has to be at your best. So it is a well accepted psychological fact that the attention span of anyone for that matter is not very long. So it applies to the customer also, unless he finds something of his need or interest. So something in your email has to capture his attention where he feels, oh yeah, this is something which I need or it is of my interest. Only then he's going to read further. So the idea is to capture the attention at, within the short span that you get the customer to read your email, you know, so that he can become more receptive. The first email therefore has to be very precise, concise, effective. It has to use very polite and simple language. It cannot be a flowery language because many a times customers will feel repulsed reading a flowery language. So it has to explain the concept in very simple language. Ideally, the introduction mail should not be more than 8 to 12 lines or sentences, I would say. So how it should be broken up? I believe there are, you know, it should start with the objective of writing the email and a very brief introduction about your company and yourself. So this opening should not be more than one or two sentences. It should then briefly talk about the challenges the industry is facing, in which the customer's company belongs, and how your product or service is going to address it. Remember the golden rule that unless you are ready to give something to the other party, the other party will not be ready to take something from you, which means that if you want to make a sale, you have to give him what interests him to begin with. And that is why, you know, I feel what you should first address in your introduction about the product or the solution that you have provided is what is in it for me, for the customer, from his point of view. So satisfying his BIFM is something which is which the mail should begin with before you actually start talking about your product. Your product should be basically able to bring out clearly the value proposition. And you know, it should not be any kind of generic description. All this has to be compressed in about 3 to 5 sentences. The next part could be, you know, like how the customer benefits from this particular product. In order to relate to that particular benefit, you should be able to give some case study or a success story of another customer, preferably belonging to the same industry, how he benefited using your product or solution. With preferably with specific numbers, like, you know, cost saving, manpower reduction, return on investment achieved, and so on. So that should be another 2 to 3 sentences, in my opinion. Then the next one is basically conclusion part, which should end the email with the proposed action. So never forget to propose the next steps to the customer. Because just giving in information about your product or service and you know, ending the email without any action points will not make any sense. Your end objective is to get a meeting with the customer, setting up a call to discuss or to demonstrate the product or service. So it works better that you propose the next action yourself and with specific timeline rather than keeping it very vague. So you may say that, you know, how about having a meeting with you next Tuesday at 12 p.m. So basically it is giving a cue to the customer that, you know, you are interested in setting up a meeting, and that kind of works positively on the customer in terms of either accepting that particular time that you have suggested or suggesting an alternate time. This should typically be done in 1 to 2 sentences. So as I said, you know, the introductory email should be 8 to 12 sentences. In the concluding part, you should also ask typically for contact details like mobile number or telephone number on which the customer can be reached, because Obviously, since you are sending the email, you have his email ID. But emails make, they don't give that personal touch. So always talking on phone gives the personal touch, wherein you will be able to explain things better. When he hears your voice, he will be able to relate to you. And that is why, in the absence of a face-to-face meeting, at least a mobile-based call will be quite helpful. Also, sometimes use of media, like, images or short videos can also make your email effective. But just keep it in mind that there should be just one or two images at the most. And if there is a video, again, the video also has to be very short. So never overdo that. The idea behind using image or a video is to basically capture the attention. You may also use a couple of fonts, or you may use your text in bold or underline or italic in order to draw attention to specific catchwords. So that is very important. In an email of 10 to 12 sentences, he needs to at a glance catch something which is very important. So those catchy words, they should be highlighted in some way. Again, that should be used with caution, because it should not be found to be too aggressive or flashy by the customer, and he shouldn't feel discouraged to read it further. The email must have an attachment, such as a success story or a product brochure, or a link should be given to any such material which the customer can read later on leisurely when he finds the main content is quite interesting. Okay. And however, there is one possibility that, when you are sending a cold email, it may get ignored. And most of the customers, probably when you send a lot of emails, 70-80% of those customers will be just ignoring the email and not responding to you. So it may be a good practice to follow up your first cold email with another email after a short gap of 3-4 days. Why 3-4 days is because immediately sending next day also doesn't make any sense. He will feel that you are pressurizing him. But at the same time, sending another email after a week or two, by that time he would have forgotten about the first email itself. So ideal gap should be about 3 to 4 days, after which you should send a follow-up email in which you can check with the customer whether he received the first one and whether he wants to take the proposed next steps. So that's how I address the cold email part of it.